So we want to talk a little bit about different toys that we're gonna play chase and catch with. There is really like wide variety, but some of the toys are good to play with, some are not. So for example, tennis balls, not a good idea, especially if you like, if you play indoors in an area like this, that's fine. The problem with tennis ball is that when it gets all wet, being from the grass or the saliva, and it rolls on the ground, it starts to collect dirt and sand. And all that dirt and sand, as the dog keeps biting and playing, files the teeth. And that happens really fast. So, don't recommend those, even though, you know, you can get so many and they're cheap. They're not the best toys. On top of that, the dogs learn how to pop them and get entertained that way. Now, I don't like tennis balls, but at the same time, if we are playing with a puppy and you're playing indoors and you get one of those little Kong squeaky toys, this will get the puppy's attention. It's light, it's easy to carry, it's easy to grab. It's actually easier to play with the little puppy because it's easier to grab a hold of them, let's say that small chuckit ball, okay? With young puppies, for whatever reason, for me, this ball is like the pretty much never really fails. I don't know what it's about. It's fairly soft. It had a squeaker, of course, that was a long time ago, but now it just makes that sound. And that sound is enough for them to get their attention and really intrigues them. It doesn't bounce much, so it's easy, it's soft, it's light, and that sound very much entices them to chase. So this is pretty much my favorite go-to ball, but there is all sorts of variations. Have to be super careful when you play which toys you select to play with. Again, tennis balls, anything that has cloth material on, anything that's gonna collect dirt and sand, not a good idea. Then we need to be very concerned about the size of the ball compared to the size of the dog. So for example, if you're playing with something like this, or even something like this, this will be with a, if we're playing with this kind of toy with a dog that it's grown up dog. Once this gets wet, again, being from the grass, from the saliva or both, that gets very slippery. The dog runs, grabs it, tries to have a good hold, takes deep breath, swallows it. Many dogs die from playing chase and catch games. It's a big concern. So as soon as you get the puppy going, try to always consider the size of toys you are playing with, because it really matters. If you want to play with a smaller one, then at least have one that's on a rope, so if it goes, you can at least pull it out. This is serious, it's not a joke at all. You really watch filing dogs' teeth or swallowing balls. These are big concerns. Now, since we are talking about concerns, before I even go further with the toys, overheating is a big deal, especially dogs that, like, let's say Malinois, that we breed selectively to have that crazy drives to play, chase. They will not stop on their own. Once they really like the games, they will not stop on their own. So it's really important that you watch for the signs of overheating. You know, like first the eyes will get watery, the ears will change color, get a little bit deeper reddish, the tongue can start to get even purple. And of course, the really heavy breathing, panting, all these signs are, you know, red flags. So be very careful, very considerate, because once a dog overheats, there is no really return back to full recovery. There is some sort of brain damage can happen. So just be very, very careful with those things. All right, so now having said that, let's go back to talking toys. Any toy that it's on a rope, they, you know, you can really go far if that's what you're trying to do. Sometimes making a really big throw long distance with an older dog, that's very, very rewarding. So think about it and definitely use that. Short throws can have some effect, but the long ones are for an older dog that is the ultimate reward. The firmness of the toy itself. See, this is much, much softer. This doesn't have any give in. So, if that toy, and they come in different sizes, of course, the heavy rubber balls, but they actually can break front teeth. Some dogs, again, super driven. They see the toy, it bounces funny, or it lands on the ground. They hit it wrong. This one gives in. You know, it has a little forgiveness. So anything of this, I recommend, and they last long time. Of course, this kind of toys, very cool. They are filled up with a silicone inside, so, you know, they can get squashed and it bounces back. It has a very nice sound to it, so it kind of entertains the dog for sure. Even if you slam it on the ground or if you kick it, it triggers a little extra boost of like, oh, I really want to grab that toy. And of course, they're big enough to where you can do quite a bit of things. You know, you have different sizes. So I like those. I like this. I like this. This one. Frisbees. Dogs love them. I love them too. But probably, you know, one of the most dangerous toys to play with, especially if you're not good at throwing. And if you have any kind of wind, that toy just can change directions and can do some crazy stuff. Dogs are very focused. They don't pay attention. Sometimes they don't even care how they're gonna get back on the ground. So a lot of times they would go vertical, they will flip back, do some crazy stuff and somehow land properly. But I have seen dogs that will just come straight back on the rear end's legs and just be injured for life, like the sport career is over because of the way you play. Similar to this, again, I really like them, but I'm very careful when I play and very considerate about wind. I think that's about it. You just need to think easy to play with, not to be destructive, easy on the teeth, easy to clean. There is again many options for you. Again, if I have to say my favorite toys here, that would be, you know, the most toys that I would play with. Any size of dolls I really like. I use them for send outs, for just regular training. But any of these three, four toys right here, those are like some of my favorites. And of course, you can see me playing as we're watching the video with all sorts of different toys. But this is the collection that I wanted to talk to you about, okay?